love, and kindness. Don Bosco also stressed on the importance of reasoning, and even today, his teachings are applicable to all sections of society. Don Bosco used to tell his students not to find excuse for faults, but correct them and encourage young people to run, jump, and shout around, but not commit sin. He also tells people that whatever you do, think of the glory of God as your main goal. And those of us who have studied in Don Bosco School, Kohima, and received his noble teachings are in some ways part of him. This celebration is an opportunity for us to reflect as to whether we are preserving the rich legacy and heritage which we have inherited from Don Bosco and our great principals and teachers. Jubilee is normally a year where people are set free, debts are forgiven, and it is a year of God's mercy, God's blessings, and God's favor. It is indeed a matter of great joy that with the launching of this Golden Jubilee today, our year-long Golden Jubilee celebration will begin. And in line with our school motto, duty and joy, let us continue to do our ordinary duties extraordinarily well with a joyful heart in the years to come. Once again, on behalf of the organizing committee, I welcome each and every one of you to be part of this year-long Golden Jubilee celebration. And I also thank each and every one of you for coming and joining this Golden Jubilee celebration here today. May the Almighty God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Kediviso, for your warm words of welcome. We all know who St. John Bosco is, but he deserves to be known more. Therefore, I now call upon Father Innocent Panmai, SDB, the Vice Principal of Don Bosco High Secondary School, Kohima, to share a brief history of Don Bosco with us all.
Of industrial revolution, Don Bosco, a 19th century Italian priest of humble peasant stock, was chosen by God to be an effective sign and bearer of his love to the world of the young, especially the marginalized. In 1859, Don Bosco founded the Salesian Congregation to continue his passionate mission on behalf of the young. 80 years in the field of higher education in Northeast India. Today, some 30,000 Salesian fathers, brothers, and sisters serve in 132 countries, the majority of them in the education mission. The global network of Don Bosco educational and social service organizations consist of 15 universities, some 110 colleges and institutions of higher learning, thousands of schools and social development centers catering to over 15 million young people.
The Salesian province of Dimapur was erected on 8th of December 1981 after its bifurcation from the Salesian province of Guwahati. The new province is placed under the patronage of Saint Francis de Sales. From 1982 till July 2018, there have been six provincials. Father Matthew Pulingathil, SDB, late Father Nedumala Skaria, SDB, Father Palathingal Varghis, SDB, Father Mulainko Thomas, SDB, late Father Punturuthil James, SDB, Father Guria Nestor, SDV. The current provincial, Reverend Father Kuruvichira Jones, SDV, was installed on 5th of August 2018 by Reverend Father Kanaga Maria Arukiam, Regional Counselor for South Asia. The province of Dimapur consists of the northeast Indian states of Arunachal Pradesh, Upper Assam, Manipur, and Nagaland. Education has been an outstanding contribution of the Salesians to Northeast India. The Salesians of Dimapur province run one postgraduate college, 6 degree colleges, 19 high schools, 9 upper and lower primary schools. The schools and colleges in Dimapur province have produced rich dividends, like the Chief Justice of India, Sri Ranjan Gogoi, the Chief Minister of Assam, Sarbananda Sonowal, the Deputy CM of Arunachal Pradesh, Sri Chaumain, and the Higher and Technical Education, Nagaland, Mr. Tenjin Inna Along, to mention a few.
The first resident Catholic priest in what was then called the Naga Hills was Father Emmanuel Bars, SDB. He reached Kohima on 31st December 1948 as a chaplain to the Sisters of the Society of Christ and Jesus from Spain. These sisters were working in the Naga Hospital in Kohima. From then on, the story of the Catholic Church in Nagaland was one of growth in spite of opposition from the brethren of other denominations. In 1951, Father Hubert Morocchino replaced Father Bars. The latter remained in Kohima till 1963. In 1965, Father Paul Burnick took charge of this mission, and in 1965, he was officially appointed Parish Priest of Christ King Parish, the first Catholic parish in Nagaland. Many Salesians have labored in Nagaland as missionaries and educators. Their enthusiasm, indefatigable energy, and valiant efforts to bring the gospel to the various tribes of Nagaland have borne much fruit. Don Bosco School Kohima came into existence on 7th February 1971. The school was started by Father Itiachan Manjil, the then parish priest of Christ King Kohima. It began from class 5 upwards, separate from the parish institution Christ King School. As there was nothing else at hand but the grand idea, the school commenced in the sacristy of the parish. Search for a suitable site for the school began, and the place where the present Directorate of School Education was earmarked by Don Bosco School. But some landowners refused to provide land for the approach road. The plan had to be abandoned even though the villagers had worked to clear the ground for constructions to begin. The search for land finally came to an end when the Kohima village agreed to give the present site to the school. The land was bought from 8 owners separately. In spite of the disputes regarding the building of the school at the proposed site, it was decided that the school be built without further delay. The disputes were concerning the leveling of the land. The villagers would not agree to level the top of the hill, as they believed that the hill was the abode of the spirits of their ancestors. To cut the hill meant desecration. At long last, after much insistence and repeated argument that it was meant for the betterment of their own children, the villagers finally gave in. Thus, while the classes progressed in the sacristy of the church, the Catholics cleared the jungles and leveled the present school building site through social work. The construction work was given to Mr. Nisalu Alexander. However, due to financial constraints, only 5 classrooms were constructed. These now form the ground floor of the present establishment. the opening of Don Bosco School as a co-educational institution was a bold step for the school as well as for the future of education in the region. In spite of the tradition of running schools for boys only, it was felt that a co-educational school was better suited to the demands of the time and society. Permission for a co-educational school was granted by the Salesian headquarters in Rome on an experimental basis. Special effort was also made to promote the Christian atmosphere in the school. The school was officially recognized by the Board of School Education, Nagaland, on 1st March 1975. The same year, the first batch of matriculation students appeared their exams. It was a proud moment for the school when all the 9 students who appeared for the examinations passed very well. On 21st August 1979, Father Kuriakos Palatinkal took over from Father Luis Arimpur. The school had only about 398 students in the rolls. In order to increase the number of the students, a school bus was introduced for the first time. Work also began for the hall, the new wing of the school, and the staff quarters. The salary of the teachers was also increased. The hall, the new wing of the school, and the staff quarters were inaugurated by late Mr. N.I. Jamir, the Chief Secretary of Nagaland, and blessed by late Bishop Abraham Alangimatatil of Kohima in 1981. The year 1981 also marked the beginning of a new section of Class 3. Around this time, a children's park sponsored by the Social Welfare Department of Nagaland, retention wall, drinking water facilities and toilets were constructed. Compound walls, blacktopping of the basketball court, equipping of the auditorium and the construction of a new floor for science laboratories were also done during this period. The school also installed video set facilities in 1983. All Nagaland Private School Association was founded at the initiative of Father Kuriakos Palatinkal, the headmaster. This body emerged as one of the significant associations in affecting decisions regarding school education. The cumulative record for classes 5 to 10, which is now issued by the Board of School Education for Nagaland, was prepared by Father Kuriakos Palatinkal at the request of the board. Common selection examination question papers for class 10 students of the member schools were also prepared by the association. Inter-school matches and various games were organized every Saturday at different schools to promote sports activities, which culminated in the cultural competition and annual prize distribution. Another thinking out of the box was the initiative Father Kuriakos Palatinkal took to begin the city bus transport service to mitigate the woes of the school children walking long distances on foot. He had the active support of the district administration. Initially, an old matador of a Catholic near CPC and a discarded ambulance of the diocese kept with Father Thomas Vatot were introduced. The bus services were introduced from BOC to Government High School, Kohima. This has gradually developed into today's city bus service of Kohima. On 5th May 1984, a new Salesian community was started in Don Bosco, Kohima. Father Kuriakos Palatinkal was alone for 1 month. Father Francis joined him in June 1984. Admission to the nursery class was taken for the first time on 26 September 1985, though classes began on in February 1986. An admission test was also introduced for class 5 students from Christ King School. It was a significant decision and also brought along with it much controversy and tension. The fourth floor of the school was built as science labs by Father Kuriakos Palatino, with donations from various well-wishers of Kohima, served in addition as a dormitory for 10 boarders, the kitchen and dining rooms for both students and the conference. On 30th September 1985, Father Kuriakos Palatingal was transferred, and on 1st October 1985, Father C.P. Matthew took charge of the school. The land problem had not yet been fully settled, and a new piece of land was being negotiated with LKEL for the nursery and KG when Father Kuriakos Palatingal was transferred. There were 596 students in the school in 1985. Father Kuriakos Palatingal left on 11th October 1985. Don Bosco boarding was begun by Father C.P. Matthew. The boarders were housed in a building for science laboratory. The year 1986 saw the introduction of computer education in the school for the first time in Nagaland under the leadership of Reverend Father C.P. Matthew and Father Tony S.T.B. The construction of Don Bosco Youth Center cum hostel began in 1987. It was designed by Father C.P. Matthew. The design and the construction of Don Bosco Youth Center cum hostel were started on the assurance of 50% financial support by the Nagaland government, which was given to Father Kuriakos Palatingal in 1985, the International Year of Youth. The government of Nagaland gave rupees 2 lakhs in October 1986 towards the foundation. Unfortunately, the work was started only in 1987. The delay was due to the hope of acquiring a small piece of land next to the present building. Even though the said land was not acquired, since Mr. Nicolier offered part of his land, the construction of the hostel was taken up in 1987. But by the time the foundation was completed, the ministry headed by Mr. S.C. Jamir that had promised help was out of power. In February 1988, Father Tony Pellissery was appointed the assistant headmaster. In a notable development, the entire school administration was computerized in 1988. It was in Don Bosco School that computerized mark sheets and tabulation were seen for the first time in Nagaland. Nagaland Computer Society was founded and computers were made available to the public. Computer training programs were organized by Father Tony Pellissery. Some of the highlights of the Bosco School during this period were the Mastermind, a quiz competition for the whole of Northeast, inter-school and interstate games tournaments, flower shows, fashion parades, computer displays and the like. The land problem was settled and the compound wall was completed by July 1995. The Catholic community, under the leadership of Catechist Philip of fond memory, was instrumental in settling the land disputes that had caused a serious threat to the good running of the school. 13 people contributed land to make an approach road on the site of the school. The Bosco Youth Center cum hostel was blessed by Bishop Abraham Alangimatatil on 29 October 1994. The housewarming ceremony of the new residents of the conference was held on 31st January 1995. In 1995, the school opened higher secondary classes in Science Stream with the idea of affording an opportunity for higher education to the financially less privileged students. On 15th May 1995, the science labs were inaugurated by the Minister of Education, Mr. Nilo Rangma, along with Bishop Abraham Alangi Matatil of Kohima and Father Vargis Palatingal, the provincial of Dimapur. In 2001, Father C.P. Matthew was transferred to Don Bosco Kohima as Assistant Director of Youth Center. He took active part in the Imagine Nagaland event and also took a group of students, mostly failed class 10 students, who were attending the coaching classes at the Youth Center to be trained in filmmaking under Mr. Mahesh Bhatt, one of the best film directors of Bollywood. In January 2002, Father A.J. Sebastian was transferred to the Moscow community since he served at the Nagaland University as reader in the Department of English. In April 2003, Father Sebastian was appointed HOD English Nagaland University for a period of 3 years. The government of Nagaland proposed Don Bosco Higher Secondary Education Kohima for the National Level Computer Literacy Award in 2006. Father Bosco, the principal, went to Delhi to receive the award on behalf of the school from the President of India, Dr. Abdul Kalam, and the Minister of Communications and Information Technology, Sri Dayanidhi Maran. The work for the extension of the school building began on 16 October 2006. The foundation was laid by late Father James Punduratil, the provincial. On 27 April 2007, there was the inauguration of the higher secondary extension building at the presence of Sri K. Sankaranarayan, Governor of Nagaland, Reverend Father Maria Arokyam Kanaga, Regional Superior of South Asia, and Father James Punduratil, the provincial. The extension of the building was undertaken with the generous cooperation and financial help of the parents, guardians, and well-wishers of the school. Father James Punduratil, the provincial, acknowledged the effort made by Father Bosco, the principal, in completing the construction with funds generated locally. In 2007, Sri Ramakrishnan, the Deputy Commissioner of Kohima, helped us with the financial support to build a gallery for the students in the playground. Later in 2007, with the mobilization of local funds, through the assistance of Dr. Surajile, book publishers, and well-wishers, two basketball courts were constructed to provide better facility for the students. From the academic year 2007, art stream was added to the higher secondary section besides the science stream. Father Maria Arokyam Kanaga, Regional Superior, South Asia of Salesian Society, visited on 22 October 2008. Father Dennis Panipichai was appointed rector and principal in 2009. In the same year, NCC for girls was introduced in the school. Mr. Bharat Prasad was given the State Best Teacher Award by Government of Nagaland on Teachers' Day 2009. In 2010, Ms. Gayatri Chetri received the Best Teacher Award by Government of Nagaland. Inter-School Talent Expo was held on 5th November 2010. The Relic of Don Bosco was received on 5th May 2011. The first issue of The Alumni, the official newsletter of the Federation of Don Bosco Alumni, was released on 7th April 2013 at Don Bosco School, Kohima. Mr. Diwakar Mishra was conferred the Best Kohima District Teacher Award on 19 September 2014. All India Don Bosco Evaluation Society organized the evaluation to enhance the standardization of Don Bosco schools in India, Adhayan, which began the internal evaluation of the school on 15 and 16 April 2016. the old Nagaland Don Bosco School basketball tournament was hosted by Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima, from 22nd to 24th September 2016. The school accorded a warm welcome to Father C.M. Joseph, who took over as rector of Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima, on 5th July. Father A.J. Sebastian was given farewell on 6th July. A special celebration was held at Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, appreciating and honoring the service of Father A.J. Sebastian in the school for several years. The governor of Nagaland, P.B. Acharya, attended the flower show in April 2018. At present, the school has 1,682 students, 559 Catholics, and 1,123 other Christian denominations and religions. There are 47 teachers, 21 Catholics, and 26 other Christian denominations and religions. There are 8 non-teaching staff, 5 Catholics, and 3 other Christian denominations. The school has very active units of NCC, Scouts, Eco Clubs, and Jesus Youth Movement. There is a vibrant unit of Salesian Cooperators with 14 members. There is also a past pupils unit in the school, Hoppers. And now the torch has been handed to us at the dawn of the third millennium. We have received a rich inheritance. Those first Salesians and Bosconians lacked many resources and had to face daunting obstacles, but they possessed something very precious, the gospel of Jesus Christ and the charism of Don Bosco. They were urged on by the tremendous love for the poor and the young, for whom they had come to offer their lives. This gave them unbounded hope and courage to face the difficulties and inevitable setbacks. With faith in God and trust in Mary, they gave themselves unreservedly to the task at hand. They rose to the challenge with intelligence and foresight. Failures and setbacks did not deter them, rather served only to bring out the best in them, molding them into strong characters, exceptional leaders, and authentic heroes. This rich legacy is ours today. The challenges we face are no less formidable, the circumstances no less trying, the task no less daunting. If we, but with the same zeal as they did, next 50 years of Bosconians in Nagaland will be no less significant. Long live Don.
History is not to be forgotten. It is to be in our hearts forever. Thank you, Father Innocent Tanmai, as the Vice Principal of Don Bosco High Secondary School, for sharing the history of Don Bosco with us all. We shall now be favored with a melodious song from Miss Vidisinho Belho. Miss Vidisinho Belho is an alumni of 2016 batch, currently pursuing her bachelor's degree at Kohima Science College, Zotsuma. She was crowned the winner of K-Pop India Contest 2020. She loves singing and has immense passion for music. The song that she is going to sing is Live the Dream. The song is about St. John Bosco.
John, little dreamer, you had so little. dream that spoke of so much truth, of so much hope, of so much youth. But dreams need no time nor season. I know this and you're my reason. I dream of rainbows lighting up the sky. I dream of children.
Let us Bosconians together live the dream of St. John Bosco. Thank you, Miss Virginia Belho, for your melodious song. We shall now go back to the struggling years, the first initial years of Don Bosco Kohima. And for this, Dr. Xavier Hiesi and Father Curaco Spalantica will take us back to the initial years of Don Bosco. Dr. Xavier Hiesi is from the first pass-out batch of our school, that is 1975, and Father Curaco Spalantica is the fourth principal of the school from 1979 to 1985. May I request you both to kindly take your time one after the other.
Respected Chairperson, our special guest, Sri Monlumo Kikon, Advisor, ITNC, Science and Technology and New and Renewable Energy. Reverend Father Paul Puna, Father Suresh, Father James, Father Kyriakos, the Salesian priests here, the Salesian family members, K.D. Wiesel, chairman of the Don Bosco Kohima Jubilee Organizing Committee, and all my dear friends. First of all, I thank God for giving me this opportunity to be with you this evening. And not only that, to be in good health, to be with you all, to celebrate this golden jubilee. At the outset, I feel very emotional because it was just like yesterday that we were running around the corridors of the old school building, which was just one floor, and there were a few classrooms only. I think there were only 5 or 6 rooms, and many of my friends are no more. Three of my classmates who appeared and passed matric with us, they are no more. Paul Solo, Angela Solo, they are both brothers and sisters. And Theodore Deo Dukru is also no more. And also from many of other friends from other batches whom I know, they are no more with us. So it pains me. But on behalf of not only my batch, but all my friends who studied with us during those years, I greet each and every one of you on this special occasion of Golden Jubilee. Well, I just want to say a few words how I came to study in Don Bosco here. It was way back in 1964 that the fathers of the Kohima Parish started a school, the first school in Peck District, and in my village, that is Porba Village, near Fetsoro Town. And I went to that school in 1964, first time I went to that school. I was just 4 years old, and I stayed in the boarding with the fathers and the teachers there. And I remember Shosahe Philip, the catechist, whom you have seen many times in the picture just a little while ago. He was the catechist, and also he was the driver who used to bring the fathers to our village. And we lived in Fetsoro Town, and that was the transit place. So there would be our guests in our home. And I remember Father Bernick, European, I think he was the parish priest here. And he used to come to the school, and they stayed in our home also. So I studied in that school, and then that school was only up to class 6. And then the 1971, I had passed out, but my father was in the government service and he was posted elsewhere. So I, for 1 year, I had to go to, in 1971, to the high school, government high school in my hometown, Fetsoro. And then it was Shosahe Philip, the catechist, who informed my father that I must come and study here in Don Bosco. And so one fine day, my first ever trip to Kohima, my father just left me in Philip's house, and he went back. And well, I stayed for some days with them, and then after that, I landed up with Father Etienne in the, just behind the church up here. in Peak Hill, and there were just a few of us, maybe about a dozen of us in the boarding at that time. And the girls stayed with the sisters in the present Christ King school building. And at that time, so we used to walk down here to this school building. And so that's still the same big corridor is there. And two table tennis boards were placed there. And whenever the bell rings for the recess, we would rush out, grab the table, and we used to, you know, fight to play the table tennis. And well, I can see two of my old friends, Helena and Arjenio. Then I remember Arjenio's friend, Arpranio, her best friend. She's no more. They were, Helena is just next after my batch, and Arjenio after that. So, but we were all good friends, and we were all very naughty. I remember I used to run up and down the corridor so many times during the recess. And it may be difficult to mention all the names, but I think many of those who studied with us during that time, I hope some of them are here at least, and they will remember. And it was, we were so naughty, so that I think when we were in class 9, 1973, Father Etty Chen wanted, there were not enough rooms anymore by the time we reached class 9. So in 1973, that extension of the one part of the building where the office, at that time that became the office. So when that earth cutting was taking place, this doctor, some of you may be knowing Dr. T.S. Anup. He is now joint director in the medical department. He fell off the edge of the of that earth cutting, you know, and he got injured. And the hill here, just behind the school building, it was a hill. There was no ground at that time. Many of the boys used to go up to the jungle to laze in the sun. And some of them used to, few of them, especially the day scholars, they used to disappear after the recess also. And then it, so then the next year in 1973, boarding hostel building was constructed by the side of the road. I think now I think that's demolished now. Yeah, I think the teachers, it was a teacher's quarter, and then that's been demolished. But at that time, we were very few. When I was in class 8, 9, less than 20, I think class 9, there were only about a dozen of us. By the time I reached class 10, there were only 9 of us. And we were the first batch to appear, the first batch of Nagaland School Board, 1975. Prior to that, it was the Naga students had to appear under Assam Board. The Nagaland Board came into existence, and the first time Nagaland Board conducted exam was in 1975. And we were the first batch, and by God's grace, all of us passed. It was 100% passed. And at that time, we used to have lots of games and sports, lots of activities. We, the first, I should say, pop musical band, rock band, was started at that time, you know. And in Kohima, the first rock band was the, I think it was called the Bosconians. And we even conducted, had concerts. At that time, Kohima had one cinema hall called Ruby Cinema Hall. and any big function is to be conducted there. So our school band performed, gave a musical concert, and not only a musical concert, even plays also. I remember that the name of the play we gave a show in the town, that was A Pound of Flesh. What was that play? Yes, The Merchant of Venice. Yes. The Merchant of Venice. And in that play, my whole classmate, everybody participated, I remember. So we had a lot of activities, and for what I am today, I owe it to the Salesian Fathers, who has brought me up. In fact, after I passed out class 9, during the winter break, I never went home. I stayed with the fathers and brothers back here, all alone. All the other brothers had gone home, but I stayed back with them. And so I used to eat with them, with the fathers and brothers. And I remember, there was this brother, C.M. Jones, who also came back as principal of the school. Then there was also one brother, Anthony, and also two Anthonys, in fact, different time. There was one brother, Anthony Patton, also, who is unfortunately no more. There was one brother, Syriac, as far as I remember. So, but then Father Etienne was the principal. When we were in class 10, in class 9, Father Etienne had got transferred here to leave. And he was so much loved by everybody, not only by the school students, but I think everybody around, in Kohima. And the day he was going to leave, the whole school, everybody cried and cried and cried and didn't want him to go. And it became evening, just imagine. His farewell was started with the, school assembly in the morning. And then after the function was over, everybody cried and held on to him and didn't go. And then he had to go and get his things from up there, from the quarters near the cathedral up here. So everybody, the whole crowd followed, and everybody, in fact, two of our girls, students, they even fainted. Yes. I don't remember the names, but I think Helena remembered their names. So they had to be, carried away on the stretcher. So it was getting evening, and so I remember Shosai again, he came. He had to intervene, and some of the elders from the village, they came, and they said, children, you please let him go, because it's getting late also, and don't worry, and they started consoling us. So finally they left. But few of us, particularly, I think, 5-6 of us who were in the boarding, we became so angry with whoever, priests and sisters who are still around, So we went and shouted at the sisters, as if it was their fault that he left. And then we were not happy with that time. I don't know, one priest was also there, and the brothers, we were very angry with them. And that whole evening we were, sort of like on a dharna, Anyway, that is how it was. And and I remember Father Etienne, since I should say personally, I was very close to him. He was already making the drawing for the upgradation of the building, the first floor. I saw the drawing of the the ground floor, then the first floor. After that, Hadron, and we will be, you know, we hope we will start this construction soon, and Don Bosco will be like this. And then he was sharing all those things with us. But unfortunately, had to be transferred anyway. The building has, I mean, what it is today is a remarkable transformation. And yes, I was just interacting with Father Kyriakos. And in 1973, when Father Etienne had gone to Europe for a few months, and he came as a substitute principal for a few months. And that is how I remembered that. And when Father Etienne came back from Europe, from his Europe tour, he gave me an overcoat, a black overcoat just like this. Okay, I remember. And he taught me a lot of magic, so-called magic tricks with cards, you know, with the playing cards. I mean, you will not think that priest will be teaching the students how to play cards, you know. But he taught me a few cards and card tricks. And he used to go for home visitation, and you know, and so he used to, I used to follow him, I used to go with him, and then with the children, you know, the children of the homes whom we visited, and he'll tell me that, oh, he's a magician, he will show you magic, and so, so he used to let me show those card tricks, you know, to the children in the village. I remember that. And so, you know, and during, so it was not all just study, but it was a lot of study also, you know, a lot of inspiration to study science, you know, came from the priests, the brothers who had taught us. And it was during one holiday I had to go home. I was going home, and so Father Etienne gave me one book, some Atlas of Science book. So he told me to read. So I read during the whole holiday. I read each and every page of that book. It was something like a science encyclopedia. And that was after class 8 when we joined as class 9. When we came back, that after the winter holidays, he asked me. So I asked him, Father, you can ask me any question from this book. So he asked me, what is the Earth satellite? He asked me that question. I said, the moon. So okay, he didn't ask me any more questions. Very good. And you know, after reading that book, I really wanted to become a scientist, you know. That was how how I went into science. And once again, I must say that, like many of my friends or like many of the seniors who are here, I'm sure that we owe a lot to what Don Bosco has done for the youth, and we all owe Don Bosco as our alma mater. And this is what I would like to share. If I've missed out some things, I may not be able to speak on the experience of each and every one, but I think this is some sort of how in the past it was. We didn't have so many, there was no hall for the morning, this thing. It was just outside, you know, just outside the veranda. We used to have the morning assembly, and so it was a very simple kind of experience, but it was very joyful. Every student knew each and every other student, and it was just like one family, and it was school was never boring, you know. We all wanted to be in school, you know. There was not even a day where today I don't feel like going to school. No, we just wanted to rush to school, and when the recess came, we wanted to rush to play, I remember. And Helena and Arino, they were also one of the, they were also among those who always rushed to be the first to catch the TT bat and to be at the table. I remember that. Yeah. So with these few words, I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Hello. Okay, before Father Kourakos take the time, I would like to make an announcement. The Honor of Baleno, NL01P7088, the Honor of Car Baleno, NL01P7088, your car has been parked in front of a garage, and the Honor needs to go out urgently, so you are kindly requested to repark your car. NL01P7088, a Baleno car. Thank you. Father Kourakos, you may kindly take your time now.
Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Kikon, Chairman of the Organizing Committee, Mr. Miso, Father James, Principal, Father Suresh, Rector, for Innocent, Father Varghese, and all the others present here, and all dear friends. We have reached a landmark in the history of Don Bosco. We have completed 50 years. And you have heard a report of what has been achieved so far. We have heard the saying that tree is known by its fruits. It is in the Bible. Now you see the fruit sitting in front of you. All the fruits of Don Bosco are sitting in front there. And they are marvelous fruits, which means tree is also excellent. I came first to Nagaland, Coima in 1970, just 23rd of December, before Christmas. We were in, as a brother in Dibrugarh, Don Bosco, and Father Rector, Father A.P. Thomas is no more. He told us, let's go to Nagaland for Christmas, and so we came up here, and I was here for 3 days, that's the first time. Then again, 1972, I just completed my regency in Don Bosco, Dibrugarh. I was due to go down to Bangalore for my theology. And that time Father Itias had gone to Rome for the chapter. Therefore Father Marius Pork, who was the acting provincial, told me, Father, brother, please go to Don Bosco. There is Father Metis alone. So they need help there. So I came up here with the Father Vijay Lewis, his brother that time. He also left the congregation. And I was here 3 months, so I taught the first batches, those 3 months that I was here. Now I want just to correct two things. One is this, that I am not the senior most principal now, it is Father Lewis. He was here before me for 3 years, 76-79. Now today he's in Don Bosco College, Thura, as the administrator. So I rang up to him and told him, this is program. He told me, please give my best wishes to everybody to be successful for the particular program. Second thing is this. The rector of this school, first rector, was Father Michael. This institution was instituted as a canonically erected, canonically means officially erected, Salesian community under Don Bosco, not under Christ King. And Father Michael was appointed the rector in 1977. He continued to be so up to 85. We happened to be staying in the parish, the residence. But officially, this was the Don Bosco community, and Father Michael was the official rector. Mine also, the others, brothers who were communities here, the official rector for all those years. After only I came down here in 1984 to stay here. P.X. Francis joined me, and then after I left 85, the next rector was appointed for this community, and then the person of Father C.P. Matthew. So that is how the community has been instituted here. I'm standing in a very familiar place. I have given more than 1,000 assembly talks from here. The store hall was not here. Because in my time only I made this hall. And then I gave more than 1,000 assembly talks from here. So this is a very familiar place for me. Now what I want to share is one or two thoughts. It is this. In the year 1980, I was sitting in a gentleman's house. And then I having tea with him, we were chatting away. Suddenly the news came on the volunteer radio, Coimbra. The results of SLC, Nagaland Board. And then I was listening attentively, and there was a small boy, his son, class 5, he was studying Coimbra English School, watching me. When the positions were announced, my face fell. And the boy told his father, look at your father's face. So there and then I decided, will that make some difference here? And as I used to go for service to Little Flower every day for 5 years. It was our job, Don Bosco's job. And Sister Ivy, as I reached the next day, he asked, Father did not get any rank. In a teasing way, he asked. I said, no, because only the names that came out normally those days were only Little Flower, Holy Cross. That was that. Then I told Sister Ivy, just give me 3 years. And then 82 we got the first rank in the state, 84 we got the first rank in the state, and a number of ranks all through, and all most of us first division, etc. Now what was my, you have seen what was done here, and there was only 5 classrooms, 6 classrooms here, then after that whatever has been built up with God's grace, a lot of people's blessings, and all that, we thank God for all that, that's been done here. But one thing I want to tell you all is this. We should never be satisfied with what is there. I always thought in terms of excellence. And therefore, wherever I go, I get into trouble. Because people are happy with whatever is going on as they are. I always look at, can we do something more for those who are here? Can we do something better if you have whatever we have been doing? And I always found there are ways. But what is wrong with all of us? Ask our politicians, they'll tell you. What I mean is, we're afraid of criticism. We never want to accept the truth. See what they're doing in the place of Delhi. I always said, we must always welcome criticism, no matter from whom and how harsh. There's always some truth in that. Look for that one. Why that man saying like this? So we not to tolerate criticism, not to welcome criticism, we invite criticism if we want to move forward. I was in Amguri 7 years. Whatever I did here, I also replicated there. Even the buildings are not there. Now classrooms are not there, but you know, they're all there. And now the school has become very big, with the 2 sections everywhere, all crowded, so to say. And there are only hardly less than 400 children there. I was 7 years there. At the end of each year, I would tell the class and students, I am going to give a questionnaire after selections are over, so they were completely free. You are assess me, assess the teachers, assess your school, assess the infrastructure, and please add at the bottom what more can we do to make your life better. Are you satisfied with the way you are trained up? Are you prepared to face the world? Can you stand on your own feet? And some of them give upright, honest answers. Some of them make suggestions from which I have again learned, can do different, better. Why are we running a school? For whom? Once I asked in the staff meeting, who are the VIPs? And the lady put her hand, she was a VIP, staff. I told there are only one category of VIPs here, the children. The school is everything there for them. I don't count, you don't count, but they count. I got a second belief. No boy or girl should fail. Failing is an aberration. In my time, nobody has failed. Why? Every boy or girl coming to a school is an average boy or girl. Nobody below average. Or they will never reach class 9, 10. Then why should they fail? Why should they fail? But some do fail. Because we have not done what should we have been done for them. I tell my teachers, I don't call you to give you a salary to teach. I'm given the job to make children learn. It is your job. I give the job to make children learn. And I want it in the results. Don't put excuses. Don't put excuses. I have brought you this job to make children learn, not to teach and go. That they do in the government schools. But we are different. And because you must understand this also. The question papers set are for the average children, not for the brightest. And the brightest get 90 or plus or above, maybe. But the average can get 35, 40, 50, why not? Then at class 8 level, I wish to identify two groups of students, the brightest and the weakest. The weakest we coached up such a way that by the time it's class 10, they have a foundation, they can perform well. And the brightest coached such a way that he can perform to his highest potential and come out the ranks and whatever may be. And that was working. It was working. There is one DC now in what you call in Mokachung, Lima Bawang. His father, a great friend of mine. And there is Sanen and what you call Alem, the other one, then youngest boy died, I think, from something, in Nakia. In class 9, after final exam, I detained him. His father was very upset. Father, how can you do this to my son? Well, that's the only choice I got, I said. One thing I tell you, I neither feared anybody nor favored anybody in my life. Never. You'll never find that I could have favored anybody or feared anybody. Even some of my NSA friends, they had to come and tell me, sorry, Father. Those days. I said, truth is truth, justice is justice. Nothing will be done. So I told the gentleman, look, your son, I can put him up, but he'll hardly get a third vision. With that, he can't reach anywhere in life. Let him repeat. I'll make him do better. He repeated. He nearly got first division. He joined St. Stephen's in Delhi. Today, see where he has reached. So it is for us to make these people come to what they want to become. And that we can do, we can achieve. But we should not be complacent with just what we our things are. When I go to place, I think I'm done. Oh, something being done, so-called light. I said, no, it's not enough. Something being done, we are not satisfied to do something being done. You have to give the very best. I always said, yes, the number of things I did, I used to feel them. But I said, this more could be done. This can be done. This need to be done. This need to be done. And things kept on improving and improving. While we reached a level, we can say we are the best, one of the best schools in the state that time also. A list of things are being done, see? So what I am trying to share with all of you is this simple thought. Let us not be satisfied with just doing the minimum. Let us always aim for excellence in every field, which means doing more, trying to do things more and more if required, or trying to do things better and better where possibilities are. And there are always possible to do things better and better. And then let us be honest enough to admit mistakes and invite criticism, honestly. Ask them, are you satisfied with what we are doing? Is there something more we can do or something we should do? Where there is some way we can make up. But we are there for them. And this is how things can move forward. So I am just, these are few things of thoughts I am sharing with you, because all the things you heard already, what good what we have done, and I thank God because so many people helped. And I want to tell you also this, I had no money. Now I didn't take any money for the headquarters. We got a little project for a part of the building, first 2 floors, the others are built later on. The rest were only goodwill of people. A lot of people had goodwill. I used to tell them, let us have this today. They said, okay, Father, we'll try and help you out. So we had to not work for ourselves. We have to go take a share of the money for our needs. We are going to invest it for others. And this investment is, when people see about the upright intentions, your integrity is there, and nothing else, no selfish motives are there, there are enough generous people coming to come forward to help out. And as I congratulate all these great gentlemen sitting down here, I told somebody, look, they are my students, but I look much younger. I am going to complete 76 in 2 weeks' time. But they tell me, so somebody asked a secret. It's a simple secret, I said. Eat less, work hard. Eat less, work hard. Here I took every day almost 4 classes every day. And that they benefited. But they knew only one thing. There is no compromise on duty discipline as far as Kuriakos is concerned. That will not happen. The rest, everything. But duty discipline by Kuriakos will not compromise. That everybody knew. And the whole village knew. Somebody remarked the village, this Father Veerana, when he will smile, the day he smiles, the world may end. I told them, come after school hours. I told him, come after school hours, I said. He was smiling. But school hours don't come and ask me to smile. It'll not happen, I said. No? So this is because we have a commitment to certain things. And that commitment should be 100%, nothing less. And if this can be achieved anywhere, we can see how things will work out. And you see all those boys and girls of those days, they are great people today, I'm telling you. I'm proud to be there. I get a number of calls from, this morning I got a call from Colombo. This Ansi Varghese, there were 3 brothers, two brothers, and she was studying here. Now she Colombo doctor, husband doctor. Number of them, the stage, they want to come for the jubilee year. They want to be informed. We want to join, they said. The ladies in Delhi, in many places asking, Father, please inform us. I got a few in my group, I mean, they're contacting me, but I told inform them, I said. They want to be involved in the jubilee celebration because they said, what we are, Don Bosco made us. If you are here today, it is Don Bosco. He said, we could never imagine our days in a small place like Coima. Those days, you remember, we Don Bosco known not only in this corner of the village only, not beyond this, that side. We could never imagine such a quality education, and that brought us all over the world now. So let us remember this. Our children are not dull. Please keep this mind. Don't instill fear into them. I tell them, nobody will fail by mathematics. I said, nobody will fail mathematics, because you can pass, what problem? I'll make sure you pass. And they all passed. Majority of the first division marks. So the only thing is, depends how we handle our children, identify the needs, try to remedy wherever possible, and then say, give them confidence. See, yes, you can. You can. And that is the confidence to give them. You can. And that they have grab on to that kind of a message, and they continue doing well. And you have said, all of these great people sitting here are all people who gone to this institution and done well in life and come back. They are written success stories. The success of the institution is the past pupils, not the institution itself. Their success story, all sitting behind us, they are success story of the institution. Not me standing here, nor the building structures, nothing. They write the success story. And therefore, what is our obligation? First of all, of course, thank God, they bless us abundantly. The last 50 years, God bless us abundantly. Secondly, God bless our children abundantly. Apart from this, we also spend some time in prayer for our children now and then, at least. It's part of our life. We do it regularly. I was afraid to work hard, I'm telling you. For 7 years in Amkuri, I taught 5 periods a day, except first and last 5 periods I was in the classroom. 7 years. I'm not afraid to, I worked hard. Well, keep in mind, those days we didn't have all the convenience we have in today. Clerk, sub-clerk, all kinds of things we don't have. We had just our one-man show with one typewriter. But all the same things happen. So let us remember this, our children are not, they are assets, they can be made into greater assets, provided we give the right support to them and tell them that you are assets, not only to society, not also, but for your future. And one first rank holder, Iftika Ali, he passed out in 84. He wrote to me, "Father, what I learned from you that day, Don Bosco, I make sure my 3 children learn exactly." And they are doing great, those 3 girls, and 2 girls and 1 boy. They are doing great, means going doing high studies are doing. That is what helped me make my children reach those same goals where I have reached today. He himself is in the States, in Seattle. He said, "We want it." So let us, we thank God, we thank all the contributed. I have a little small regret now. I am missing one person. I don't know if anyone of you is missing. That person's name is Tarsisius. He labored here 38 years. 77 to the day he left, so 1915. He is one man who was a key person here. He gave 100% of his self. And nobody of you sitting had a complaint against him. Did you have? No. Did you know? That much dedicated service he has given. So I believe, or I have requested past pupils, you must find out where he is. I don't know when he left, what was given him, but I think he deserves to be treated royally. Given something that lasts for life. You know, I don't know what condition living there in Bihar, but he sacrificed life for this institution. 38 or 39 years of service, and most dedicated service. Never a complaint, never missing a duty of 1 day. You know, it's all witnesses. So I think we should honor this person greatly for whatever he done for the school. As an individual, he given 100%, maybe more than all of us. He has served 30, 39 years. Nobody has served longer than that, I don't think, or will ever serve. But therefore, he all deserves recognition, appreciation, and we should keep the poor man and his family in mind as we celebrate this particular occasion. I wish all of you a great success in the days to come, and I hope that you will go on grandly as all of you are capable people. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Xavier Ihesi and Father Kurikos, for taking us back to the past as a student and administrator, as well as encouraging and motivating us to do better. Music is to the soul what words are to the mind. We will now be fed with a musical piece from Vizoko Nagi, Javier Hurie, and Gideon Tono. Vizoko Nagi is an alumni of 2008 Beige. He did grade 8 in classical piano performance and grade 6 in piano rock and pop. He is currently teaching piano at Music Academy Kohima and music theory at Greece High Secondary School. Javier Hurie is an alumni of 2008 Beige. He did his bachelor's in music from Margaret Shishak School of Music. He has performed with the Indian National Youth Orchestra in 2015 and 16. He is the proprietor of Oli Music Studio. Gideon Tono is an alumni of 2003 Beach. He completed bachelor in composition in the year 2015 from Trinity University of Asia, Philippines. He is currently the music director of Ringma Baptist Church, Kohima, and also the music director of Halal School of, sorry, he is also the music director of Halal Music Center, Kohima. We have Vizuko Nagi on piano, Javi Huria on violin, and Gideon Tono on the cello. Thank you so much, Visoko Nagi, Javi Hurie, and Gideon Tono for the melodious musical piece. Ejibali is incomplete without greetings, so we have Father Dr. P. Suresh SDB, Rector and Principal of Don Bosco College, and Father T.P. James SDB, the Principal of Don Bosco High Secondary School, Kohima, with their greetings. May I request both of you fathers to kindly take your time one after the other.
Grace and peace to you from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 2. I thank Ms. Ruth for giving this opportunity and this time to stand before you to give the Golden Jubilee greetings. As I was pondering what to say, I asked the Lord, and the Lord gave me this verse, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 2. Grace and peace to you from God the Father and Lord Jesus Christ. So I greet you that this year of Jubilee, Golden Jubilee, may be a year of grace, may be a peace-filled Nagaland, peace-filled Kohima. And this can come only from God. So let our celebration be rooted in God and focused on God. My greetings to you, dear Bosconians, our special guest, Mr. Kikon, our convener, Mr. K.D. Vizo, our secretary, Mr. Peter, and all Bosconians. My greetings to you, Salesian confreres, Father Kuriakos, Father Jonas, Father M.D. Varghese, Father Paul Punner, Father Rang Anthony, Father T.P. James, and Father Innocent. My greetings to you, sisters, daughters of Mary Help of Christians, sisters from LFS, sisters from LFS Novitiate. My greetings to you, Salesian cooperators. We have with us Mr. Linus and his friends. My greetings to you, the past peoples of this school, of all the Salesian institutes. My greetings to you, dear staff members, the parents of this school, and to all other members of this beautiful and great Salesian family. We also have missionary sisters of Mary Help of Christians, Sister Teresa and community from CPC. We also have with us Father Richard, Father James, sisters from Bethany Convent, sisters from Medical Mission Convent, sisters from FCC Convents. Greetings to all of you. Dear Bosconians, as you celebrate this Golden Jubilee, we assure you of our prayers. We prayed last 9 days. We had the novena to the feast of Don Bosco, and we as a community every day we prayed 1 hour for the success of today's program, and we'll continue to pray for you, for your family, and for your dreams. Dear Bosconians, I warmly welcome you to this campus, Don Bosco Kohima, as you know, as Father Kuriakos was describing, and Sir Zavi was describing how it has transformed. It is going to transform more. The Kohima village people are dreaming of a university, Don Bosco University. So we all pray that this small dream of Father Itiachin may become a great vision. So we are all here, part of this dream. The door of our DB Kohima will always be open for you, and moreover also the doors of our hearts. Here I have put the eyes of Don Bosco. All my life I was in Don Bosco school, from nursery till my college studies. I like Don Bosco, I love Don Bosco. And it is his eyes, a loving eye. He always liked young people. For him, enough to be with young people. Dear friends, you are here, Boscoans, you love Don Bosco, you want to come back because someone has loved you. It would have been your principal, it would have been Tarsus Hughes, it would have been your teacher. Someone told you, you are good, you are precious, and that's why you are here. That's why you all came and hoisted the flag, you kept this lamp, because someone loved you. Someone told you, you are good, you are precious. I am here because one father told me, Suresh, you are good, you are innocent. But still, I am not innocent. But long way to go. Don Bosco's heart was beating for his young people. For he said, for you I study, for you I work, for you I live, for you I am ready even to give my life. And he gave his life for his boys. We Salesians, we are here, three of us, Father James, Father Innocent, myself. And in Christ King also Salesians are there. Some of them are thinking Salesians are not in Christ King. We have wonderful Father, Father Paul, Father Rang Anthony, Father Watto Thomas. So we are one family. Even though we are two communities, we are one family. We are for you. We are for you, Bosconians. We are for you, young people. And we are here to listen to you. We are here to labor with you. We are here to be part of your dream. Today, more than ever, we the Salesians ask you, dear Bosconians, you have come here today to be part of the celebration. One thing that we want you is, as Father Kuriakos told, we need healthy criticism. We want you to help us. Many of you are here, have studied much more or have better experience than us. So we need your help so that we can give our best. So help us that we never disappoint you, that our mission may flourish, our mission may grow, many young people may profit coming into this campus. Dear Bosconians, the most precious thing we have and that we can offer you are not the houses, this campus or this playground or the buildings that we have, but rather the most precious thing we have is Jesus Christ. The most precious thing we can offer you is an encounter with God, our Father who loves us. Dear Bosconians, Don Bosco dreamt that his boys and girls will meet God in this campus, and in him they will discover the meaning of their life. Dear Bosconians, Don Bosco wished that you all be very happy in this present life and in eternity. Be happy. Make your families happy. Let everyone who is around be happy, especially during this Golden Jubilee celebration of our Don Bosco Kohima. With affection in the name of Father Don Bosco, I greet you once again. May God bless you all.
A very good evening to you, my dear Bosconians. It's a good evening, Father. In the first place, I would like to wish every one of you, my dear Bosconians gathered here in this hall, and those who are online streaming, a very happy feast of Don Bosco. Today, the 31st of January, we are keeping the feast of our father and founder, Don Bosco. And I would love to name each one of you right from the start here, starting from Father M.D. Verghese to the last man at the back there, wishing you and greeting you in the name of Don Bosco. But due to shortage of time, without excluding anyone, I would like to include everyone and wish and greet you in the name of Don Bosco. Here we have before us great persons, both past and present, students, teachers, and fathers who have worked here. People who were instrumental in laying the foundation and giving a good direction in the pioneering work in the past 50 years. I, as a sitting principal, would like to thank you for making Don Bosco a golden Don Bosco today. When the world witnessed the end of an era with the death of Napoleon Bonaparte, God brought into the world another hero in the person of Johnny Bosco, born on the 16th August 1815. Every age has produced great men. They changed the lives of individuals and of society. Don Bosco is one among them. Don Bosco was a God's gift to the youth of the world. With his wonderful system of education based on reason, religion, and loving kindness, Don Bosco was able to enter and touch the lives of young people and to transform them into good children of God and useful citizens of the country. As we enter into this Jubilee year, let me propose to you a program from the numerous teachings of Don Bosco himself. Don Bosco used to speak of 3 S to his young people: Sanita, Sentia, and Sentita. Sanita means health, Sentia means knowledge, and Sentita meaning holiness. My dear friends, life is God's greatest gift to every one of us. Therefore, it is our duty to protect and preserve and also enjoy good health. Sinners, as several of you are here gathered this evening, great care of your physical well-being is a necessity now. COVID-19 had taken its toll on the lives of individuals and of society. Besides, many other forms of illnesses and ailments continue to worry the family. Healthy and moderate food habits and restraints are a must for our well-being, along with various physical exercises. The same needs must be inculcated also in our children. Dear elderly people present here, you are still very much needed in our society. Your presence and contributions are essential for the ongoing growth and transformation of today's society. Next, knowledge is power. We are sons and daughters of Don Bosco, who read and wrote many books during his life. We are never too old to learn. The child in you to learn should never die. We should all be knowledge keepers and idea givers to the young entrusted to our cares. Our reading habits and intellectual curiosities must continue to shine and inspire young people of today. And why not writing about the good old days of our village life, of our school life, and the enriching experiences that we had in different phases of our life. It will be a wealth of knowledge and an information that can be passed on to our next generation. Holiness. Don Bosco frequently spoke of reverence to God and of being grateful to God. So much so that Don Bosco equated gratitude to holiness, saying, "A grateful boy is a holy boy." We have every reason, my dear friends, to be grateful to God for so many years of blessings we have received in our life, in our family, in our children, our schooling, and our good health, and a host of other things. We need to count the blessings of our life and let it prompt us to be caring parents, more committed leaders, and inspiring members of our society and of our church. A society that is all embracing and opened to all communities of all people. Let us take to heart these thoughts of our Father Don Bosco and make it happen in our lives during this Golden Jubilee year. As I conclude, let me thank all of you for your presence here this evening, and may Don Bosco intercede for you and for your families, and may he bless you all from heaven. Long live Don Bosco. My dear friends, don't forget, duty and joy is our way. Thank you, and God bless every one of you.